What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, it's going to be a little bit different. I don't like doing these sit-down commentaries, but my internet's been messing up to the point where I can't even really get on the game without lagging, and I can't really do a live com. So that's why we're doing the sit-down commentary today. But, you know, I really don't do these videos, and I don't do update videos. This update that's coming April 10th is the biggest update ever for Call of Duty World War II, and honestly, it's going to be game-changing. It's going to change World War II into a completely different game. I even saw Pamaj tweet out saying Call of Duty is getting a new game April 10th and something like that, and that's pretty much the case. There's so many changes coming to World War II that I wanted to make this video and let you guys know, regardless of it, if it's a live condom or not. I'll probably have like a V2 gameplay in the background though for you guys to keep entertained, something like that. But let's jump right into it. Let me know your guys' thoughts down in the comment section about this update after I'm done. Don't forget to drop a like on the video, and let's just jump right into it. So before I talk about the overhaul of the divisions, which is the main focus around this update, I wanted to let you guys know that they are removing primed basic training out of the game entirely. They felt like it was a crutch perk and they just overall wanted to remove it. And the way they fixed this and kind of like, you know, replaced it was they gave every single division a third attachment. So now you can run three attachments off your gun on the start. I think infantry might get four, since that's one of infantry's like traits, is that they're allowed to have a third attachment. Not entirely sure yet, but primed is being removed out of the game. So with the divisions, what I want to talk about is the division set attachment that each division gets. You know, infantry gets bayonet, airborne suppressor, armor, the bipod, stuff like that. All of that is going to be removed in the sense of you are no longer forced to have it. So for infantry, you can take off the bayonet and not have it on there as an attachment anymore. And I think that's actually kind of cool, because what this is allowing us to do is, for example, say I want to run mountain division and I want to run the STG with a bayonet. I can do that now. If I want to run mountain division with a PPSH and have a suppressor on it, I can now do that. So I felt like that was actually a very good move, and just all overall more customization in the game and more variety, which is what World War II needs. And I've mentioned this multiple times, as well as airborne, as well as the suppressor. I was hoping we were able to do this on all weapons, but the suppressors are actually going to be able to be put on pistols as well, because I was watching Drifter's video and he's actually running around with a 1911 akimbos with a suppressor, and I thought that was very, very cool, and very, very cool that they actually ended up doing that. So infantry division gets automatically a second pistol attachment, and they get to swap weapons faster. That was really the only update they got. Airborne gets built-in hustle, which is you get to reload guns while sprinting or diving or something like that. So they get built-in hustle as well, which is pretty cool. Armored division got a pretty big buff. What armored gets is basically it took primed and put it into armored, greatly reduced flinch when shot, as well as armored has built-in FMJ on all the weapons you use. So if you use a Lewis or you use a PPSH, I'm pretty sure you have built-in FMJ into all those weapons. Mountain division, you no longer give away your enemy death locations, which is actually pretty cool. Expeditionary, you get to run double lethals and double tacticals as well right off the bat, which is actually pretty cool. And equipment damage paints the enemies on the mini map. And then resistance also got added with basically like a sit rep pro type of deal, where they are allowed to hear footsteps a little bit louder, kind of coping with all the type of stuff the resistance division does in terms of being like stealthy and whatnot. So a huge thing that I was actually so excited for World War II to actually add into this game is unlimited sprint. So they are actually adding unlimited sprint into the game. They are completely removing the limited sprint, which I thought made the game super, super slow. And honestly, I was just not a fan of it. I really wanted to just have unlimited sprint ever since Black Ops 3. Like when I played Black Ops 3, going from Black Ops 3 to other Call of Duties that just don't have it, it just makes the game so much slower. So unlimited sprint is making a return, and I feel like this update is just making the game better and better and better, which is awesome. So yeah, we covered unlimited sprint. Each division is getting a brand new fourth perk as their very last unlock, reattachments for all primary weapons, and we also get a piece of lethal and tactical equipment for all loadouts off the bat. They're also adding two brand new basic trainings into the game. Blitzkrieg, which is streaks are earned by kills instead of score, and streaks are improved, as well as you can select a fourth score streak or kill streak in that sense, which I think is really cool because this rewards the players that actually go for a lot of kills. So even if it was domination 50 points per kill, if you were running Blitzkrieg, you would get your UAV in 5 kills, you would get blah 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 and so many amount of kills, as well as your score streaks are improved. So your paratroopers will be better, your ball turret gunner will be better, stuff like that is very, very cool. So I think a lot of players are going going to like Blitzkrieg because it's going to focus around you just grinding out some kills and going for those high kill streaks. And then there's another one called Kladestein. I think that's how you pronounce it. It's slain enemies drop intel packs that reveal nearby hostile enemies. So like kind of like a ping. So at the start of your every single life, you get one ping off the start to see where everybody's at. And every time you kill someone and you pick up this pack, you are allowed to get another ping that kind of gives you an awareness about where people are at. So it's actually kind of cool that they are doing that. You know, the basic trains, they're kind of adapting and getting more variety into the game, which is absolutely insane. There's so much more to go into, guys, but that's like the main things I wanted to talk about. Also, we are getting a rifle grenade that is going to be available for all assault rifles in the game. So when people think of that, they think of grenade launchers, and that's what it is. I did watch some gameplay on it from a few other YouTubers that got flown out, and apparently, you know, they don't look like they're super broken or overpowered, but they look like they can be annoying. So we are getting grenade launchers, unfortunately, into this game, but overall I think it's still going to be very good. So that's going to be it for the video, guys. I just wanted to make this video real quick and tell you guys about all the new changes that are coming to this game, because I am very excited for these updates, because it's going to be game changing. Hopefully they add stuff later down the road, such as, like, you know, I'd love to see Ground War, Infected, just, you know, some more camos, a lot of stuff to grind for, and just a lot of things to, you know, play the game and enjoy it more. An advanced UAV would be awesome. And before anyone says you can't have an advanced UAV, what happens when you call in three UAVs in the map at the exact same time? You get an advanced UAV, so don't give me that crap. But hope you guys did enjoy it. I'm probably going to leave you guys with another V2 rocket that I got earlier or something like that. Hopefully you guys did enjoy today's video. Make sure you guys drop a like, subscribe if you guys are brand new, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.
I'm gonna fuck 40 kills, man. Three deaths sitting there running around with the golden gun, man. Who the fuck is you, man? Who that? It ain't you, man. Hell nah. That sound like a kid. It ain't you. Hell nah. Oh, you got your kid talking to me and shit.
On Tuesday, which is when the DLC will release, and I just slayed all those guys out there. But hopefully we don't run into any issues. I hopefully fixed my PC, and we should be good. If I didn't fix my PC, well, your boy's gonna go order a new PC, because I'm tired of not being able to stream how I want, when I want, because my PC acting up. How's my day been? Yo, my day's been good. I mean, it's only, what, 11:30 right now? So my day, the day hasn't even really started, or really, like, completed. Get out of here, bro. I want you to know you don't have to go to school. You don't have to go to school? Why don't you have to go to school? Get wrecked. Oh my god, you suck. And you suck. Nope. You suck. Hold on. Did they all just back out? They all backed out but one guy. I see how this is. They just don't want to play against me. Okay. Freaking not even fair, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, my lord. Oh my god. Can we please drop? Oh my god. That was the worst, like, accent I've ever tried to attempt in my life. I want to drop a V2 first game on. Oh my gosh. We're so close.
Oh,
guys. Okay, so I get this. Let's drop, guys. Let's drop it like it's hot. Baby up. I think we're one kill off. Let's go! First game on and we drop, boys! I told you, we ended the curse last night. Last night we ended the curse. First game on. Boom. game's easy.
Oh, fuck.
Oh my god.
She said, I die for you. You're like my drug, but I can't get high off you. You're not mine anymore. Hey, I still remember what you wore.